guys, welcome back to No Case Your Name. It's me, Ella. This is the 2018 crochet tag that's been flying around. Every crocheter's already done it, and I'm late, as usual. It's like the third week of January, I think. What is it? The 20th, yeah. It's 20th of January, which is Saturday. I'm filming it today, but I'm not sure when I'll put it out. Probably sometime next week, because I uploaded yesterday and today already. So, anyways, I've got tagged in this by a lot of people. I don't even know who's all tagged me. I know Terry did, for sure. I think a few other people have. I don't know. There's little fuzzies floating around. I've stirred up something. Anyways, I got some written down, so I'm going to read them off. I actually tried filming this once before, but my camera died, and I just got aggravated and didn't try again. That was a couple weeks ago. So it would have been on time had I not been so angry at my camera. But alright, let's just hop into it. Number one, which of your current whips are you most looking forward to finishing in 2018? Alright. I don't really have any long-term whips except one, and if you've watched me for a while, you know what it is. It is the Grease Corner-to-Corner Crochet Along, hosted by Chaos and Chop Suey, that I was participating in when it was going on, and then I fell behind. You know, life happened, I fell behind, and now it's in hibernation. I do want to finish that this year, though. Like, that's a goal. I actually have it written down on my phone in my notepad as one of my craft goals this year. But I'm not going to be, like, hard on myself if I don't finish it. I would really love to finish it this year, but it's not the end of the world if I don't. I have, let's see here, Pink Ladies, T-Birds, the Comb, the Rydell High, and the Long. I have five pieces of it done. Excuse me. I have five pieces of it done, and I have another one about a third of the way done. And then there's quite a bit left. I don't even know how much. This blanket's going to be huge. I made it normal corner to corner with, I think, an H-hook. Yeah. So it's going to be like a king-size afghan. I wish, in retrospect, I should have made it in mini corner to corner like I'm doing Terry's Christmas crochet along that she's hosting, because it wouldn't have been as huge and it wouldn't have taken forever in a day to finish. But I do want to finish it. I may actually omit some of the squares and just move them around to make a smaller blanket. And maybe, like, I thought I could use some of the littler squares to make a pillow with one square on either side. So I could still make the squares, but not have a ginormous blanket. Because I had intended that blanket to be a couch blanket, but if it comes out king size, I don't want it on the couch. Because, you know, Jesse and all that, it'll be just all over the house. Be in the middle of the floor and all that. But yeah, I do want to finish that blanket. It's paid for pattern, but I'll link it below if you're interested. It's a really cool pattern. I like it a lot. They're so loud. They probably say the same thing about us, though. But, anyways, I will link it below if you're interested. It's cool. She's got some other ones, too. She's got a Friends one that I would love to do. And a Gilmore Girl one. I think the Gilmore Girl one is a free one, but the Friends one is another paid-for one. And the Grease one's paid-for. Yeah. Alright, anyways. Number two. Which project are you most excited about starting in 2018? I already started it, but I did wait till 2018 to start it, I think. I can't remember. But it's my afghan for the county fair this September. It's my secret project, and it's only because I don't want someone copying my idea. I know that sounds horrible, but, you know, I'm going to keep it a secret up until I enter in the fair, and then I'll show y'all. It's probably going to take me that long to make it, because I used to be able to pop out afghans in, like, a week. But I guess since Jesse, I haven't. I've been horrible at making afghans. Like, I mean, it's a good month if I make a baby afghan. But the one I'm working on is going to be a full-size afghan. But, you know, in that category, it's like an adult-size lapghan. So it's not going to be ginormous, but it's going to be, you know, fairly big. I posted a picture in my last crochet talk, black and white, so you could see the color of it, of the width of it. And it's pretty wide. I'd say it's like 3.5-4 feet. I don't know. I haven't measured it. It's pretty wide. But I'm excited about getting that all the way done and putting it together, the parts that go to it and all that. And hopefully it comes out the way I'm envisioning it in my head. Because I am doing it without a pattern because it's pretty basic. I am using a few applique patterns and stuff to put on it. But for the most part, it's just me winging it, which I've not done that before. Too much. I think I made like a headband and a hat winged, but other than that. So hopefully it turns out good. Yeah. Number three. Are there any new crochet stitches or techniques you'd like to try in 2018? I could gosh, I'm a burpee. I'm sorry. I was drinking a soda. Well, I moved it. It was in the background. But, any new stitches or techniques? Not that I can think of right off the top of my head, because, you know, I've been crocheting for, like, 17 years. I've tried almost everything. There's only a few things I've stayed away from, only because I didn't think I'd enjoy it, and one of them is broomstick lace, because it just seems too complicated and annoying for me. I don't even want to attempt it. I'm not even interested in it. The major one that I wanted to try and did last year was Tunisian crochet, and it was okay, but I don't think I could see myself doing large projects in it. So, I don't know. There's some stitches I'd like to work with more that I have done before, but I'd like to work with more and make bigger projects with. I'd love to make a crocodile stitch something. Like, I would love to make a crocodile stitch afghan, but that would take so much yarn and so much time, I don't know. And it would be really thick and heavy, I would think. I'd like to make, like, a waffle stitch, or basket stitch, what's it called? Waffle stitch? Waffle stitch. Afghan that looks like a giant waffle. I think that'd be cool. With, like, a pat of butter on it. But, other than that, you know, I basically use all the stitches that I know of, and, you know, most of them I already know how to do. So, there's nothing new. And I don't know much techniques, maybe. I don't know. We'll see. I would like to make some dainty, like, doilies with little tiny thread and little tiny hooks. But I don't know if I would enjoy working with a little tiny hook. Number four. What is number four? Will you be participating in a cow in 2018? Yes. Easily, yes. I'm already in one right now, and it's Terry's at the Yarn Joy Podcast Christmas Blanket Cow. And I didn't do Mary Smith's this month just because I was out of fiberfill, and I didn't want to be behind, so I will get fiberfill before, what is next month? February. And I will more than likely join her next month. I'm hoping her February one is like the leprechaun or something, because I need to make the leprechaun for a decoration for March. And I like doing cows because I like the community of it. I like having a deadline for some things just so I can get, like, I'm not a big shawl maker, but I would like to join a shawl cow so that I would actually make a shawl, because I've made a shawlette. I'm working on a shawl right now, but it's not part of a cow. It's just because, but I like the community of it. You know, talking to other people, doing the same pattern, seeing how everybody's comes out different, even though it's the same pattern. I think that's so neat that they're all different. And I also like the fact that most cows, you can win stuff. I've never won anything, but I'm going to keep trying until, well, I've won patterns through Mary Smith. But a lot of cows give away, like, stitch markers or patterns or yarn and stuff. And, you know, it's fun to just try to win. I'd like to host a cow, too. And I might do that once I get a few more, you know, more subscribers. I think I have 450-something right now, which is awesome. But I plan on having a giveaway maybe around, I would say 500, but I don't know. You know, that could be next week, or it could be next year. I don't know, but I have to get stuff for a giveaway. But anyways, back to this. What am I on? Five? Do you have any yarn goals for 2018? I do have yarn goals. Not major ones. Like, I don't want to de-stash or nothing. I never understood why people do that, because I like having a stash of yarn all the time so that I always have what I want. Like, if I see a pattern that I want to make, I want to be able to go get the yarn and make it without having to go to the store. So, but I would like to use up some of the yarns that I don't use much, like the variegated, the self-striping, the cakes, things like that I bought just because everybody else was buying them and, you know, I was in the heat of the moment. I'd like to use that stuff up. Because I mostly use solid colors. You know, anyone who watches me knows that I make a lot of amigurumis or decoration type thingies. I don't know if you can see those back there. But I need solid colors for those. And so I do want to use up all my variegated and cakes and things. And I'd like to keep track of how many yards roughly I use this year. Just to see how many yards I use by the end of the year. I think I have a couple more. Let me grab my phone. I'm always grabbing my phone in my videos. But that's alright. Craft goals. Oh, this is not crochet related. It says yarn goals, but I'll say craft goals anyways. I want to learn how to interface bags and sew zippers, but to do that I'm probably going to have to get a new sewing machine, because I'm pretty sure mine is dead. I haven't messed around with it yet, because it's still my mom's, but it's probably dead, because it's like a cheapest, I think it was like 70 something dollars at Michael's 2 or 3 years ago, whenever it was. But, like, I don't have a lot of craft goals this year. Just because, I don't know, I'm just not the kind of person who does that. Number 6, which projects would you like to see more of in 2018? This was a hard one for me to think about, because it's like, I don't know. I can't really think of anything that I would like to see more of. I would like to, I guess, more movie and cartoon-themed amigurumis would be nice, but I know a lot of those are copywritten, you know, about all of them, so you have a chance of getting in trouble for making them and selling them. I guess you can make them for personal use. I can't think of anything right off the bat that I would like to see more of, per se, but I would like to see maybe more crocheters. I have nothing against knit, and I know a lot of the people who watch this channel crochet and knit, but I like, it seems like a lot of the podcasters start off crocheting, and then once they start doing knit, they switch to only knit and never go back to crochet. So I'd like to see more people focus on crochet more. You know, like, I'm crochet only. Terry is mostly crochet only. She does knit some. Randy mostly crochets, but knits some, you know. I would like to see more people crochet only. Oh, that sounds bad when I say that. I don't know if you understand what I'm trying to say, but I just, you know, I only crochet, so I'm only interested in crochet. I mean, I there are people who I do watch that knit. Like, there's some podcasts that I watch are pretty much only knitters, but I like watching them because I like the people who do them. But yeah, now I sound like a bad person for saying that. But yeah, I'd like to see more crocheters, more new podcasters would be cool. There's been a few popping up. And I plan on making a video soon about podcasters, but I've said that like a bajillion times, but I mean it. It's written down. number, what, 7? This is a shout-out to fellow crocheters you'd like to see more of in 2018. Just like everybody else said, there's a lot of them. So I can't name them off without pulling up my YouTube and seeing everybody that I'm subscribed to. And like I just said a few moments ago, I do plan on making a video of all the YouTubers that I do watch, craft-related, crochet-related, pretty soon. I'm going to try to get that out pretty soon. And, so that's pretty much, like, everybody I watch, you know. I love watching, like I said, Terry, Randy, Sonia. I suck at remembering people's names right off the bat. Y'all know who y'all are. Claudia, Gerard. I always say his name wrong. I think it's pronounced both ways, depending on where you're from. But just everybody. I got so many people that I'm subscribed to that I love watching. And actually, I have like 30 watch-laters that I have to catch up on now that JC's at his grandparents. So I'm going to be watching YouTube videos all day. Everybody's going to get comments from me tonight, probably. Saturday, January 20th, you'll get a comment from me. 8. Are there any projects... Okay, are there any projects you made in 2017 that you would like to make again in 2018? There's probably a lot of them. There's some I know for sure I'm going to make again. Like some of the amigurumis that I made, I'm going to make again. Because I have people who want them. And I don't want to give mine away, obviously. So I'm going to have to make new ones. And the Christmas lights that I made, those were really popular around here. Everybody wanted them. So I'm probably going to have to make some more of those. And, I don't know. That's probably about it, because I didn't really... Most of the stuff I made last year was for the fair, so it's kind of like a one-time-only thing. They're making noises. And 9 is to tag someone. I can't really tag anyone. Everyone's already been tagged. There's a few... Let me look on... Let me scroll through YouTube real fast to see if there's been people who haven't been tagged. But I'm pretty sure, like, almost everyone has uploaded a video. Let's see here. Has she? Yep, she did it. See, everybody clicking on. I don't know. Just anyone who has not done it yet, I guess. Because it's going to take me forever to scroll through there. If you've not done the 2018 crochet tag, do it. Post it. Even if it's your very first video, if you're interested in podcasting... I still don't get why people call it podcasting, because it's not a podcast. But anyways, I'm just going to go with the flow and say it. If you're interested in podcasting, just do it. When I first made my first one, other than the very first one I did was a giveaway entry for Margaret Olander's giveaway, but then I decided, you know, to start making actual podcasts. And the very first one was very awkward, and I actually did a tag video for the very first one just to kind of introduce myself. So you could totally go watch that video and steal all those ideas, you know, questions, and do it yourself, and that can be your introductory video. Excuse me. Or just make a video on your phone this way, not this way. Hold it this way. And, you know, of what you did the last week. That's, you know, that's what all we're interested in. We like seeing what you're making, what you've made, what you bought. Everybody loves seeing what you are and the stuff you buy, and to get to know you. So if you're interested in podcasting, just do it. That's all I have to say about that. And I finally did the crochet tag. Woo! I deserve something. I don't know what. I got a package in the mail today that I wasn't expecting, but I was. I forgot that I was expecting it. That's random. But that's my reward for today. So, this is a wrap up the 2018 crochet tag. I keep wanting to call it something else. I don't know what I'm wanting to call it. So, I'm going to hop up here. I am losing daylight, so I hope this isn't dark. It is 3:30 in the afternoon here in Tennessee, so it's going to be getting dark in an hour and a half-ish, maybe. So I'm going to hop up here. I got some cleaning to do before Jesse comes home, and I think I might film another tutorial video or two. Trying to cram in all my filming today because Jesse's not here. And Devin's at work. He had to work this weekend. So, yeah, I think that's it. So I'm going to hop off here and do all that stuff I just said. And I always repeat myself at the end of videos, but that's okay. But I'm going to go binge watch all my YouTubers because I got to catch up with them. Clean. And crochet. So I'll see you guys in the next video. I don't know when that will be. It could be before next Friday, or it might be the next Yarn Talk. So I'll see you whenever I see you. Bye, guys.